What can I say about Dark Souls except it's too easy? I've seen it all. Dark bead builds, power withins. No, forget all that. We don't need any fancy tricks to beat this game. Just our fists and some claws. Today, we beat Dark Souls as Wolverine. I named my character Logan because obvious name is obvious, and we picked the thief class as it has the highest dexterity. We also take the old witch's ring. That's not really important, but there was nothing else I wanted because thief already starts with the master key. Let's go over the rules real fast. It's beat the game as Wolverine. I mean, it's in the title, I don't know what else to tell you. I guess to be a little more structured, it's kill all bosses using only our fists, the cestus, or the claw. Basically like a fists only run, honestly. So now, we have to show this big, thick demon boy who's boss. Okay, 30 damage, that's not bad. What about a regular punch? Oh, well, that's a problem. Okay, so we don't hit very hard, like, at all. Even with a jump attack, we still only do 3 damage. But I'm nothing if not dedicated, and after a measly 17 minutes, we shield pose on the Asylum Demon in victory. The plan is to get the claw weapon as fast as possible. It's available from Shiva of the East after joining the Forest Hunters Covenant. In hindsight, I actually could have went there right now, but in the moment I was terrified of how little damage I was doing, so I just wanted to get the cestus. So, we go down into New Londo, through the Drake's back door, into Darkroot Basin, and pop up next to Andre. Here we buy the brass knuckles that will be our weapon placeholder before we get our adamantium replacements. Unfortunately, in Dark Souls 1, you actually can't two-hand your fists. No wonder everyone's depressed. So that's off the table, but let's test these babies out. Okay, that is simultaneously awful damage while still being literally 10 times stronger than what we did before. Cool. We fist the big knight for his big stones, then decide to punch a demon. I really just wanted to test out the damage on a boss, and 278 for a plunging attack ain't half bad. 29 sucks. Now that I think about it, I don't think we can even plunging attack any other boss. Huh. Ah well, if we can't do it on any other bosses, we might as well double dip, no, triple dip fist the Taurus Demon. So while I keep beating up this bull boy, let me talk about the issue with fist weapons. The damage isn't stellar. In fact, it's pretty bad. But they can be upgraded and buffed to be at least somewhat decent. The biggest issue is the range, or lack thereof. You practically have to be inside of the enemy to do any real damage with your fists, and even then, sometimes you miss. The claws feel like they have more range, but we'll talk about that when we get there. For now, I need some souls, and I know just the big scaly red drake to help us. First, I avoid the Hellkite Drake. I said I avoid the Hellkite Drake. Mr. Drake? Did you not learn your cues? Joke's on me, I forgot if you don't activate the Hellkite Drake earlier in Undead Burg, he just never shows up here. I guess I'm the stupid one. So we run back, nearly get stepped on, then we avoid the Hellkite Drake and he barbecues a few dozen hollows for us. We use our new souls to buy the Crest of Artorias, open the door, and pledge our life to Alvina the Cat. Shiv of the East is just outside, but he won't sell us anything just yet. Guess he doesn't want Alvina to know he's peddling souls on the side. We make a quick trip down to everyone's favorite swamp town, and here we can buy the claw. Only one for now, because we're the poor man's version of Wolverine, but it's fine. Hey, buddy, that's a nice rock you got there. You wanna get me out of this hellhole? Thanks! So the claws have a couple things going for them. The rolling R1 is actually a second roll into a stab, which is good for closing the distance. But the best thing about them is they have an innate bleed. That's great, because, surprise, as a fist weapon, they hardly do any damage. Unfortunately, not all bosses can be bled, but that's for future me to worry about. For now, we head up to the Bell Gargoyles. 17 damage on a light attack and 42 on a strong attack is, not what I would call optimal. They can be bled, and that's good, but when the second one joins in, it gets a little more difficult to keep up the pressure to actually proc bleed, and, yeah, I expected that. Okay, let's try again, but this time with a secret weapon. Lightning. Oh, that is much better damage. We still sometimes struggle to actually hit the boss, but it's an easy win this time. Then I realized the real issue with this run. You can't shield pose on anything. 0 out of 10 weapon, never doing this again. We ring the bell, then head over to Andre to make our claw a +5 and use the rest of our levels for dexterity. Because we have a bleed weapon, I think it's a good idea to get Thick Boy 2.0 out of the way. The souls will be a nice early boost to our damage, so we head on back to the Undead Asylum. Huh. Who knew Wolverine's natural predator was fire? Dropping in on a stray demon, I'm not really picturing him to be an issue. I mean, he'd probably one-shot us if any of his attacks connected. but we can avoid that by just staying behind him. Our damage is, pretty bad. Like, really bad. But the bleed is just so good, it basically procs every 3 hits, and that's unfortunate for him. He tries to sit on us, but we have a tight schedule today, so no time for fun, and after a few more bloody punches, we net a cool 20k souls. I was honestly more afraid of this Black Knight than I was of the Stray Demon, and, well, I guess my fear wasn't unfounded. This time I confront the Black Knight like the way the real Wolverine would, like a Chad, followed by Chain backstabbing him into oblivion. Hey, it's Lautrec! So with our shiny new donated ring, we head back to Blighttown. Rock is nice, my friend, but not today. Today we fight Spider Bay. Now let me tell you, if there was one demon in this game I wanted to fist it, Quelaag is tanky, and for the umpteenth time I'll say we don't do a lot of damage. According to the wiki, she isn't actually terribly resistant to bleed, but let me tell you, I hit this boss many, many times, and she never bleed. Maybe it can only be procced on her human half, I don't know, but after about 8 minutes of smacking her legs around, she goes down and we ring the second bell. We use the old witch's ring to be more depressed listening to the fair lady talk about how much she loves her sister who we just shish kebabbed like 5 minutes ago, and then it's off to fight Ceaseless Discharge. You know, I've made a lot of bad jokes in this run with more to come, so I'm gonna leave this one alone. Instead, we use our fist to beat him off the cliff. Oh dang it, since I'm stuck using the claw, we might as well make it stronger, so let's head over and grab the large ember. To do that, we make our way out of Blighttown and into Lower Undeadburg. If you weren't convinced this weapon sucks, here, just watch this. Yeah, now imagine that, but the whole playthrough. Into the Capper Demon fight, I'm not really sure what to expect. Okay, I expected that. Oh, I am living on that superhero plot armor right now. Not once, but twice did I almost die, and the game just said, nah, you can live. After getting rid of the dogs, Capper himself isn't really much of an issue. After a few slaps, he goes down. We grab the large ember, and since I'm here, I decide we might as well kill the gaping dragon, that way I don't forget again. Hey, that's not terrible damage. I mean, his head is the weak point, but it could be worse. There isn't much else to say about this fight. He stomp, we slash, he puke, we win. We take our ember over to Andre and upgrade our claw to a +7. It ain't much, but every little bit helps. The Moonlight Butterfly is annoying. In fact, we almost die. I'm actually kind of embarrassed to say that out loud. We swat the very clearly a magical moth boss, then it's time for Sin's bounce house, baby. The trip up Sin's fortress really isn't eventful. Funny snake man get run over, we smack the wall because game hates us, you know, standard stuff. The real issue is the iron golem. Well, why is he an issue, you ask? He's pretty slow and predictable, you say. True, true. But, counterpoint, big iron man made of metal. Metal doesn't bleed, and we do yeah, that much damage. Okay, it's fine. We'll just hit one of his legs and then we knock him off. Okay, round 2. We actually are able to break his stance, but we didn't do enough poise damage to knock him over. I guess we're in it for the long haul. I wasn't really afraid of the Iron Golem. I just knew if we couldn't bleed him. I'm a little afraid of the Iron Golem, but only because I knew he was immune to bleed, and if we couldn't poise damage knock him off the ledge, we'd have to chip away at his ankles. It took a few minutes and... Oh, are you kidding me? Alright, whatever. He's dead, and I'm in Interlando. We parkour our way through the giant city until we meet up with Solaire, the man who abandoned me, grab Havel's stuff, then take on the Dream Team. Let me make you a nice numbered list of why this fight is hard. Number 1. It's Orenstein and Smo. Number 2. Our weapon doesn't have very much range. Number 3. We hit like a wet noodle. Number 4. Orenstein and Smo. We take down Orenstein first because honestly there's only enough room in this city for one big O, and that comes after this fight, and I just kinda prefer fighting Giga Smo. The problem is, he too wants to sit on us. I bring my clop to a +10 just to get a little bit more damage, and just one attempt later it pays off, so we head up and see Guinevere, Queen of Sunlight. Now let me tell you, if there was one goddess in this game I would fist it. We take the Lord Vessel, put it in the giant cup holder, and now we can finally warp around. First destination, Blighttown, so we can buy the second claw and finally complete the Wolverine look. We upgrade the second claw for a reason I'll explain later, but there isn't any dual wielding in this game, so for now it's just a sick looking parry shield. Ironic, because the next boss is Sif, who can't be parried. Sif doesn't think our dual claws are all that cool, so we have to put her down. We head into New Londo, and Wolverine ain't scared of no ghost, but I am scared of kings that come in sets of 4. So we grab the very large ember, take it to Andre, upgrade our claw, and then dive headfirst into the abyss. So this is a fight I was worried about. The 4 kings are a DPS check, plain and simple. The issue is even with a plus 12 weapon, we still only do 111 points of damage a swing. On top of that, this undead boss has the nerve to have no blood to bleed. So, we just have to swing our limp noodle claw at them until they fall down. The biggest issue is this huge AoE attack. Wolverine doesn't use shields, so we just kinda need to take it. And it's not long before we're chopped to pieces. I decide we just aren't ready for the Four Kings, so instead we head to Duke Archives. It's not running away, it's a tactical retreat. While we're here, it'd be a good idea to grab the broken pendant, so we kill this golem and... Why can't things ever just go my way? We go up for our tactical death by Seath to get tactically thrown in jail where we murder this guard and escape. Tactically. Ladies? Yeah, still into it. Through Hogwarts and into the Crystal Cave, we have our rematch with Seath. Come here, you big dumb dragon. I'm gonna slice ya. I'm gonna dice ya. I'm gonna turn you into dragon calamari, and then I'm gonna... Okay, that's fine. At least we didn't get cursed. Okay, so I'm actually kind of struggling with Seath more than I thought I would, so after curing our curse, we do the only logical thing. We become Mysterious Traveling Havelman.
Yes. Through me, you win.
The real reason we wore such broken armor was for the extra curse resistance, and sure enough, Seath goes down on the very next try. Thank you for lending me your armor, Mysterious Traveling Havelman.
Good to miss you, loser.
Right. Anyway, our next stop is the Scenic Demon Ruins. Demon Fire Sage is... Well, I guess happy to see us. He keeps jumping for joy. It's literally just the stray demon, except on fire. There isn't much to say. But now, it's time for our revenge against the centipede demon. Do you have any idea how much pain you caused me in my pyro-only run? Oh, you're immune to fire? Well, are you immune to cold hard steel? No. The answer is no. And the centipede demon goes down first try. That is satisfying. Making our way through unfinished content land, we eventually arrive at everyone's favorite boss, the Bed of Chaos. Yep, I expected that. Believe it or not, I actually did this boss first try without the quit out strat. I know, right? Must be hacking or the power of Wolverine, I don't know. Either way, two lords left. Before them, I think we should take on a few more optional bosses, so we head over to the catacombs to take on Pinwheel. I don't have to make a joke here because Pinwheel is the joke. We grab the Dark Moon Seance Ring and warp to Anor Londo. Mr. Gargoyle? Can I help you? Are you gonna let me rest? I mean, that's fine. I guess you could live. Ah, I see. 'Twas I who was the fool. Dark Sun Gwendolyn isn't really a problem. I mean, annoying with all that teleporting, to be sure, but after we run him down, he too falls to our mighty fisting. Up next, the Painted World of Ariamis. Like always, we jump the fence, run past the goopy boys, get Dark Souled, jumping fist the butt, then enter the chambers of the true queen, Priscilla. Now let me tell you, if there was one dragon crossbreed outcast in this game, I would fist... I hate to do this, Priscilla, but I have to get back to the other world. Bosses need killing, you know how it is. We throw ourselves off the cliff and make our way back to New Londo. Once again, we don the armor of champions and plunge into the abyss. The plan is to just face tank everything while dealing as much damage as possible. Sure enough, the Four Kings have met their match and they go down. I should really find a way to thank Mysterious Traveling Havelman properly. We head over to Darkroot Basin where we take on the Hydra. Guess he wasn't very headstrong. He didn't have a very good head on his shoulders. Not a good time to lose one's head. Hey, wait, this isn't an Austin Powers run, it's a Wolverine run. We chop up this gold member golem, ouch kabibbles, and can finally go back and get the broken pendant. Before we get yanked around by Manus, I want to finish off the final lord, Nito. But we have a problem. So Nito can't be bled, he's literally a pile of bones. And to make it worse, he has some infinitely respawning skeletal friends that want to join in on the party. But we planned for this. Remember how we leveled our second claw? It was for this, so we make it a divine plus 5. It's not going to be doing any real damage as our faith is kind of trash, but it's not for Nito, it's to put down his bony buddies permanently. Fight starts off a little rocky, we even got parried at one point, but Guinevere's bountiful bouncing light shined upon us and we didn't get insta-murdered. After a few swings, Nito falls before our cardboard claws, and with that, it's DLC time, baby. Sanctuary Guardian is... not an issue. He can be bled pretty easily, so we just have to wait for our openings. Eventually, he goes down. The next fight... is an issue. Knight Artorias. He's fast, he's strong, and he's angry. Remember what I said about our abysmal damage? Yeah, Artorias' speed makes him pretty hard to hit, and when we do land one, it does, well, practically nothing. We might as well be tickling him with a feather at this point. It was clear we were going to need to rethink our strategy. And it's here that I remembered a little trick of the claw. The rolling R1. You see, up to this point, it's been kind of useless, honestly. Every time I tried to use it, it would whiff or put me in a disadvantageous position. But something about this fight, it actually worked pretty well. Our first roll lets us avoid damage, and then the rolling attack actually puts us in range and is fast enough to recover before he can retaliate. It takes the better part of 15 minutes, but we eventually roll our way to victory. We grab the silver pendant, mine the gap, yoink the crest key, then make our way to Papa Manus. My, that's a big fist you have there. You know, have you ever considered a career? I wasn't particularly worried. I mean, he hits like a truck and can move fast, but it wasn't long before I discovered Manus shares the same weakness Artorias did to rolling R1s. It took a couple tries, but we proved to be the superior fister and Manus goes down. Last in the DLC Boogaloo is Black Dragon Calamine. Oh boy, I can't wait. Calamine has a lot of health and resistances. On top of that, he hits really, really hard, and we don't. If you somehow haven't figured it out by now, the claws kinda really suck. Sure, in the early game, they aren't so bad, and if a boss bleeds, it isn't a terrible fight, but for literally anything else, they're awful. I don't know what Ultra Instinct Wolverine mode I tapped into, but on only my second try, we take Calamine down. Only one fight left. Descending into the kiln, I wasn't really sure how to handle Gwyn. I mean, he is parry bait, but the problem is he has this one really annoying fast attack that's impossible to react to. That one. I only dodged it here because I preemptively rolled away thinking he would do it, but about 12 seconds later this happened. So yeah, that attack is pretty dangerous. Gwyn gets the best of us a few times, so now we gotta pull out all the stops. We make our claw a plus 15 and wear Mysterious Traveling Havilman's armor one more time. I mean, he's never gonna play this game anyway. At least he can beat the final boss vicariously through me.
What was that?
What? Nothing. I didn't say anything.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Okay.
With a patent pending tank and parry strat, Gwyn is no match for us, and Wolverine links the fire. Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching. This run was an interesting one. It definitely wasn't the worst run I've ever done. It might be the worst Dark Souls 1 run, at least so far. But the claw and most of the other fist weapons aren't actually that bad. They're just kind of held back by their abysmal range and the fact that it basically tickles most late game bosses. All in all though, it was a fun short run. A huge thank you to my friend Traveler, the voice of Mysterious Traveling Havilman. He doesn't stream or do any videos, so I can't plug him, but if you can show him some love in the comments, that'd be great. And if you made it this far, please consider giving a like and subscribing. It really helps me more than you know. I have some exciting things planned for videos that will span more than just Dark Souls 1 and Elden Ring, so I hope everyone's looking forward to that. I do stream these challenge runs every weekend over on Twitch, so if you wanted to stop by and say hi, that'd be awesome. But until next time, my friends, don't you dare go hollow.